It's universally accepted in Rockford that the Coronado is a valued asset of our community. And there are several others like that, but that is the example where you really have a base of people who get it. Hi there. My name is Einar Forsman. I'm president and CEO of the Rockford Chamber of Commerce. Yeah, you know, I was born in Chicago, Illinois. I actually lived the first 4 years of my life across the Museum of Science and Industry. I don't remember much because I was so young, but I'd moved to Texas for a period of time when my father's career took him there, and then we came back to the Chicago suburbs. So I'm the youngest of five people, so I grew up in Hinsdale, Illinois for 20 years. And I did my undergrad work at Southern Methodist University in Dallas, Texas, in political science. Got my master's degree just down the road here at Northern Illinois in public administration. It was early 80s. It was just kind of like now, unfortunately, where the economy was very challenging and finding employment was quite difficult for someone with a liberal arts degree at that time. And so I really had wanted to pursue advancing my career earlier than I did, but also wanted to have a master's degree at some time. And when I did come to Rockford, and I'm in my mid-20s and came here in 1986, I was rather surprised that I'd grown up in a community and an environment where there was really just a total college orientation, higher education orientation, and then I came here, and I was surprised that it was much less emphasized in the community, really. It wasn't that sense of desire. My parents were phenomenal people. They both were working professionals, and they committed their lives to putting us all through private colleges or universities. I always thought, when I'm doing all the yard work for the house, I'm the youngest person, I've got to do all the outdoor work, and I always say, why is my dad so cheap? Because we're buying all this, we don't have a riding lawnmower, we got this yard lawn. All the tools we have are cheap and they break all the time. And I kept thinking, why are we doing things so cheap? Well, it was because he was saving money to put us all through college. Years later, you realize and respect what they were doing, but at the time, you're like, boy, it just seems like we're living hand to mouth. And here my parents put five kids through college. Probably three of us were in private colleges at the same time for 3 to 4 years in a row. So my dad's writing big checks, my mom's writing big checks.